Hello, Aquarius. This is Citrina, and this is your July 2018 astrology forecast. Let's get right into it because there's a lot going on this month. We have two eclipses, and then Mercury is retrograde. So let's start off with talking about the full moon. The full moon this month is going to happen on July 27th, and it's going to be a total lunar eclipse. Okay, so remember, a full moon can be a very emotional time, and by it being a total lunar eclipse, you can definitely expect this to be an emotionally charged time. Okay, now let's talk about lunar eclipse. A lunar eclipse is when the Earth is between the Sun and the Moon, and most of us will feel the effects of this. However, Taurus, Leo, Scorpio, and Aquarius will feel the energy the most, okay? Secrets will come out at this time. Anything that has been holding you back that you've been wanting to release out of your life, the eclipse will help you eclipse it out of your life, okay? So just remain calm during this time because it can be a very emotionally charged time. Okay, so that is the total lunar eclipse. Now also another thing that's fueling the fire with this total solar eclipse is the fact that Mars is in Aquarius with this full moon. And even though Mars is retrograde, Mars can still bring out anger in people. Okay, so just remember that. Now let's backtrack. Let's look at Mercury. What's going on with Mercury this month? Because Mercury goes retrograde. Also, as far as the full moon and Mars, they're both in your first house. The first house deals with your outlook on life, your appearance, your demeanor, your personality, things of that nature, okay? So, Mercury. Mercury will be retrograde July 26th through August 18th. And for you, Mercury in Leo is in your seventh house of partnerships. Okay, so when Mercury is retrograde, it's not a good time to sign contracts. It's not a good time to book travel. It's not a good time to buy electronics. Why? Because Mercury rules communication. It rules travel, things of that nature, okay? So if you want to sign a contract or if you want to buy electronics or book travel, it's best to wait until Mercury moves out of the retrograde period. Okay. Now, if you have travel that's already booked, that's fine. You know, I mean, you might expect some delays, but you should be fine as far as traveling. But as far as booking travel, you might run into some snags trying to book travel when Mercury is retrograde. I mean, you can still book the travel, but just know, just be patient if you run into any problems. Okay. Let's talk about Venus now, because Venus is going to be in Leo in your seventh house of partnerships until the 10th of the month. And then on the 10th of the month, it moves into Virgo, which is in your eighth house, dealing with other people's money. It deals with shared resources. It deals with your transformation. It also deals with sex. Okay, so let's compare the energy of Venus in Leo to Venus in Virgo. When Venus is in Leo, it's all about splurging. It's all about painting the town, you know, dressing up to the nines and going out, you know, having a wonderful time. It's all grandiose. Now, when Venus is in Virgo, that is more of a frugal energy. Okay, so just keep that in mind, because if you're dating, when Venus is in Virgo, that energy tends to be more of an analytical energy. You know, more of an energy where you're sitting back observing your date or observing your partner. This is the energy where you see a lot of people break up during this time because you're so analytical during this time. So, now, for you, Aquarius, Venus is in Virgo in your eighth house. So, if you're dating someone, you will find yourself being very observant around their, about how, what's going on for them in their eighth house. So or the eighth house matters. So you'll be sitting back looking at how does this person feel about sharing resources, you know? How does this person feel about transformation in their lives? You know, like, are they trying to do anything, you know, different with themselves? Are they working towards a goal that's going to bring about transformation in their lives? Things of that nature. Okay. Also, when Venus is in Virgo in your eighth house, you're going to be very observant about what type of lover they are. Okay. Because Venus in the eighth house does deal with matters surrounding sex also. So if you are dating someone and you want to impress them, it's good to let them know that you're all about transformation. You're all about improving yourself. If there's any area in your life that you want to improve, it's good to let this Aquarius know, while Venus is in Virgo, it's good to let them know that you're all about improving yourself, transforming yourself. Okay. Things of that nature. So just keep that in mind, okay? Because it is a very different energy than Venus in Virgo. Venus is in Virgo, you're not really observing them very much. I mean, as long as you're having fun with the person, you're fine with the relationship. But when Venus is in Virgo, you are observing them relating to the area that it falls in for you. For you, Aquarius, Venus in Virgo falls in your eighth house, dealing with other people's money, shared resources, sex, transformation. So those are the areas that you're going to be very observant when it comes to your partner. So just keep that in mind, okay? Now, let's keep moving on, because this next one, Mars is retrograde all month. It's been retrograde since last month. So this is pretty much just a reminder to let you know that Mars is still retrograde, and it will be retrograde until August 26th. Now, for you, Mars falls in your first house. So remember, when Mars is retrograde, it really doesn't want to do anything. So as far as changing your look or your outlook on life, you won't want to do anything like that while Mars is retrograde. So just keep that in mind. Let's look at Jupiter. Jupiter goes direct on July 10th. Right now, Jupiter is retrograde, so it's just thinking about what it wants to do. So for you, Jupiter in Scorpio falls in your house of career. Your house dealing with career and what you're known for in the world, things of that nature. So it goes direct on July 10th. So anything that you've been thinking about doing in your career or changing something in your career, you'll start seeing action in that area after Jupiter goes direct, after July 10th. So that's something to look forward to. Now let's look at the Sun, because the Sun is going to be in Cancer until July 22nd. And after the 22nd, we can start telling all of the Leos happy birthday, because it's going to be Leo season. Let's get into what else is going on this month. So the Sun is squaring Uranus on July 25th. Now it could happen a few days before or a few days after. So what this means is that you can expect to hear unexpected news around this time. And hopefully it's good news, but because this is a square, more than likely it's going to be something that you really don't want to hear about. You really won't be crazy about hearing this news, okay? It could possibly be good news, but just so that you are prepared. The purpose of this astrology forecast is to let you know what could possibly happen, okay? And a lot of times it's not all, you know, roses and daisies and, you know, just wonderful life. So when you are forewarned, you can prepare yourself, okay? So that's just what this is about. Let's see where these planets fall for you. So for you, the Sun is going to be in Leo in your house, dealing with partnerships. And then Uranus is going to be in your house 4, dealing with home and family life. So some type of unexpected news you might hear is that maybe your partner moves out, or maybe your partner loses their place. Let's say you're dating someone and they're evicted from their place and they need somewhere to stay. They have to, you know, move in with you. That's unexpected news. Things of that nature can happen under this transit. Now, it could be news about anything, but for you, because the sun is in your house dealing with partnerships and contracts, and also Uranus is in your house dealing with home and family life, you could hear something in relation to those two areas. Also, house 7 is the house of open enemies also. So just watch out for that. It could be an open enemy in your house. So just prepare yourself. This is just to prepare you for what is possible. I'm not saying that these things are going to happen, but it's more than likely going to happen, okay? Now, let's look at the new moon. The new moon is going to be in Cancer in house 6 for you, Aquarius. House 6 for you is dealing with your daily work routine, your health, and your vitality. So, and now, this is not just a regular new moon. This is a partial solar eclipse, okay? And we all know new moons are all about new beginnings, right? So by it being a partial solar eclipse, this is going to be an energy dealing with transformation and taking action. Now, let's talk about solar eclipse. A solar eclipse is when the moon is between the sun and the earth, okay? Now, most of us will feel this energy. However, Aries, Cancer, Libra, and Capricorn will feel this energy the most. And this is an energy that can affect us for the next 6 months. However, this is a preview to what you can expect next year. Now, this new moon will be in opposition to Pluto. So you might, around this time, you might hear about some type of world crisis or some type of drama, okay? So just, you know, prepare yourself. But this is a great time to take action. Anything you've been trying to transform, it's a great time, okay? And it falls in your house dealing with your daily work routine and also your health and your vitality. So at this new moon, it's good to sit down with pen and paper and write down your wishes for your health and your vitality. Write down your wishes for your daily work routine, okay? That's good to do at every new moon. It's good to sit down and write what your wishes are, okay? Now, I'm going to pull one card to see what the cards say you should concentrate on at this new moon. Let's see, what does Aquarius need to concentrate on at this new moon in Cancer? Aquarius. Ooh, this one wants to come out. Solar plexus. You need to balance your solar plexus, Aquarius. That one fell out, so I'm just going to pull another card, okay? The solar plexus is right above your belly button. So you can get, trying to see if I have a yellow stone around here. You can get, like, let's say get a citrine stone and just put that, lay on your back and put that stone right there on your solar plexus to help balance your solar plexus. This is telling me that you need to get in touch with your intuition. Start following your hunches, Aquarius. But I'm pulling another card. I'm just going to pause the video and get a stone for you. Okay, I'm back. So if you don't have a citrine stone, this is a great stone for balancing your chakra. Lay on your back and put this on right above your belly button. That's where your solar plexus is located. It's located right above your belly button. Okay? Get this stone and just meditate with this. This is a citrine stone. I picked this up in Sedona a few years ago. Sedona is one of my favorite places. I mean, I've traveled all over the world, but Sedona is one of my favorite places. The energy there is just so amazing. So anyway, try to get you a yellow stone. This is your solar plexus is all about being in touch with your intuition, following your gut. So if you feel like you haven't been following your gut, then that is a good sign that your solar plexus is out of balance. And in order to balance it's good to get a yellow colored stone. It doesn't have to be citrine, it can be some other yellow colored stone. It can be yellow jasper, it can be anything. So try to balance your chakra. Now I'm going to pull one other card for you to see what you need to concentrate on besides balancing your solar plexus, what you need to concentrate on at this new moon. Give it one more turn. What does Aquarius need to concentrate on at this new moon? Mental conflict. This ties in so much with this solar plexus card. You have a lot of mental conflicts going on with you. I'm just looking at your chart. Yes, I'm looking at your chart, and you have Pluto and Saturn in your 12th house. Pluto is the planet of death and rebirth. Okay, Pluto wants to tear everything down so it can rebuild everything. So right now it looks like you do have some things that you're conflicted about surrounding anything dealing with subconscious topics. So whether it's, you're confused about what church to go to, whether you're confused about whatever, is going on with you. You have some mental conflict that this solar plexus, balancing your solar plexus, is going to help you with. So at this new moon, write down everything that you worry about. Write down everything you worry about and meditate. Hold your yellow stone and meditate about everything you're worrying about. You're putting everything into this stone so the stone can help you work through this. And you're going to balance your solar plexus at this new moon, Aquarius. Let's keep moving on. Okay, so let's talk about the new moon. Not the new moon, the full moon. The full moon is going to be in Aquarius, in your first house on July 27th. This is going to be a very emotional time for you because the full moon is going to be a total lunar eclipse. So this is like a full moon on steroids, okay? So let's talk about a lunar eclipse. A lunar eclipse happens when the earth is between the sun and the moon. Now, most of us will feel the effects of this. However, Taurus, Leo, Scorpio, and you, Aquarius, will feel this energy the most, okay? So remember, remain calm around this time because a lot of secrets can come out during this time. And also, anything that you've been trying to eclipse out of your life, this total lunar eclipse will help you do that. Anything that you've been trying to let go, but you just haven't been able to do it, the eclipse is here to help you eclipse it out of your life. So just keep that in mind. Now, remember, this will be an emotionally charged time, so it's good to remain calm. Now, what I want to talk about is everything happening this month. I have grouped them into two different groups. The first group I'm calling the Take Action group. The first group is Jupiter going direct in your 10th house, and I'm coupling that with the new moon in Cancer in your 6th house, okay? Because now they're not aspecting each other, but I'm coupling them together because they're happening within the same time period, okay? So I'm calling them the Take Action group. Remember, wherever Jupiter is, Jupiter wants to expand. And for you, Jupiter is in your house dealing with career. Jupiter wants to expand your career, okay? Aquarius, Jupiter wants to expand your career. Now, it's been retrograde, so it really hasn't been making anything happen for you lately. But some of you have started to see Jupiter, the effects of Jupiter being in your career house. So by Jupiter going direct, Some of you who Jupiter has been kind of slow in that area for you, when Jupiter is going direct, you're going to start seeing more things happen in that area for you. Now, let's move on and talk about the second group. Now, I'm grouping them together according to when they're happening. I'm not saying that all of these are aspecting each other or anything like that. I'm just grouping them together based on when they're happening. Okay, so the second group, I'm calling this second group the emotional gang. Okay, we have the sun going into Leo. That's about drama. I'm a Leo myself, so I know all about Leo drama. Okay, so we have the sun going into Leo. That's drama. The sun square Uranus. That's unexpected news. Mercury retrograde in Leo. You can expect things to go haywire. Then we have the full moon in Aquarius. That's an emotional bag of energy waiting to bust. And what's going to bust it? Mars. Mars is retrograde, but it's still Mars, okay? So we have the full moon, which is a total lunar eclipse in Aquarius. And look who is there. Mars is already in Aquarius, okay? Even though he's retrograde, he's still powerful, okay? So I've been telling the story about the vicious dog this month. So if you have ever experienced a vicious dog in the neighborhood where every time you walk past the gate, the dog is barking and growling and trying to get at you. Well, one day you walk past the gate and the dog is not barking. So you feel like, oh, I can go over and pet the dog. He's not barking today. And you go over and reach your hand out to pet the dog and he bites you. Why? Because a vicious dog is a vicious dog, whether he's barking or not. Okay? Same thing with Mars. Mars is still Mars, whether he's retrograde or not. Mars can bring out anger in people. So around this time, you might find people lashing out at one another. You might find people having emotional outbursts, things of that nature. So between July 22nd through July 27th, remain calm and remember, you can expect to see people just having emotional breakdowns. Now, one thing that's going to help us get through this period is the fact that Uranus and Saturn are in a good connection to one another, and they're both in Earth signs. Remember, Earth signs help us to stay grounded. So that's one thing that's going to help us get through this. And another thing that we can look forward to is that Venus is forming a bond with Pluto towards the end of the month, and they are both in Earth signs. So that's something else that's going to help us to stay grounded. Now remember, for you, Venus is in Virgo in your eighth house, and then you have Pluto in Capricorn in your 12th house. Okay, so that's some things to look forward to this month. And now, if you have liked this video, please press the like button and also share the video and subscribe to the channel. And if you would like a reading with me, you can contact me. I have my description information in the box below. And until next month, Aquarius, have a great month.